Just jump in. Jump in all you have to see. Ready, set, go! Hello guys, welcome back to our channel. So today we are doing a DIY, right? How to make Starbucks drinks, more specifically the caramel frappuccino and the mocha frappuccino. So today's video is gonna be different because I told myself I am going to speak Spanish the whole time, explaining my own thing, and she's gonna speak her own thing. They're gonna be the same drinks.
Overall the same, just chocolate and caramel. That's the only
caramel
difference.
Is the only difference.
And that he's doing, but something's a little different.
So starting from
we are going to be making mocha frappuccinos and caramel frappuccinos. We went to the store and got all the ingredients, including a blender, which we didn't have before.
It's a really cheap one. You can get it anywhere.
It's not really cheap.
It was $19.95.
Yeah, there was cheaper ones.
Well, yeah.
This was probably like the middle. I don't know.
It's pretty simple too. And both of our ingredients combined were a total of $20.45.
This should be pretty simple. Like we said, he's doing a couple things differently.
He's
putting sugar in his. I am putting different milk. I'm putting a certain milk. Just that, but overall, it's the same.
Empecemos. Buenas. So good in Spanish. Bueno. Buen día a todo el mundo. El video de hoy se trata sobre hacer. Buen día a todo el mundo. Buen día a todo el mundo. Hoy vamos a hacer unos jugos de Starbucks que se llama caramelo frappuccino y mocha frappuccino. Y vamos a hacerlo en la casa. Let me restart again. Buen día a todo el mundo. Buen día a todo el mundo. En el video de hoy. El video de hoy voy a hablar español. Alia va a estar a mi lado, pero ella va a estar hablando su inglés. Y hoy voy a tratar de hablar español en todo el video. Hoy vamos a hacer unos jugos de Starbucks, caramelo frappuccino y mocha frappuccino. Lo hemos investigado en YouTube y son bien fáciles. Hoy fuimos a comprar una licuadora porque no teníamos. Una licuadora bien barata que se consigue en cualquier parte. Nos costó como $19.95 y después fuimos a comprar los productos que necesitamos. En un momento les muestro todos los productos que van a necesitar. Es bien fácil y al menos a mí me encanta ese los jugos de Starbucks. Bueno, vamos a ver los ingredientes. Empezamos en 3, 2, 1. Bueno, estos son todos los ingredientes. Al menos para mí, vamos a utilizar el caramelo, mi leche de almond y este French vanilla para darle sabor. Y el café, por supuesto. Y para Lía.
We're both using coffee. I have my milk, I have sugar. And my chocolate syrup. We didn't get whipped cream also because he didn't want cream, so then I was like, I'm not gonna whip cream myself.
El whipped cream, no sé. No, una cosa.
Yeah.
Apenas acabamos de abrir el blender. Licuadora. Pero bueno, es una licuadora sencilla. Como le digo, es bien barata. Una sencilla, como le digo, que puede encontrar en cualquier parte. Bueno, no sé honestamente qué pasó con el liro, con el cosito pequeñito que va aquí en el Keurig. Creo que lo dejé en el trabajo. Nos tocó improvisar y utilizar esta cosa que compramos
en la tienda de 99 centavos, que simplemente pones el agua caliente aquí, café también, y después le pones esta cosa aquí. Los granos de café quedan en la parte de abajo y el líquido queda arriba. Ok, ponga dos copos de café en el contenedor. O sea, van a poner dos copas de café.
How much? Like a tablespoon?
Sí, una. Dos copas.
What they said three.
Well, una para usted, yeah, una para mí, and then una extra.
Okay, so three.
Put una, yes. Three, yes. Tres.
Are you sure you're supposed to put it there and not up here?
No, you're supposed to put it here. Yo creo que está supuesto a ponerse aquí. Vamos a ver. Ahí miramos a ver si hace bien. Esta es la segunda, son dos copas. En los videos que estamos viendo, decía que el café tenía que estar bien fuerte. Honestamente, depende como usted lo quiera. Aquí vamos a hacer tres copas, tres tablespoons de café. Como le estaba diciendo, dejé la copita esta donde uno le pone el café para poder que lo colara en el trabajo. So, tenemos que improvisar con esto. En estos momentos vamos a... vamos a hacer esta opción.
Make sure it's strong.
Yeah, but I think it's strong. And then, yeah. Esta. Y ahí sale el agua. Creo que va a salir agua. Ojalá que salga agua. Así. Eso. Café puro colombiano. 100% colombiano. Bueno. So, ya casi está el café. Después hay que dejarlo que repose. Ay, mira, Queenie. Hace poquito le hicimos un recorte. O sea, tiene un recorte nuevo. Parece un oso pequeño. Ok, so el café ya está listo. Ok, como le estoy diciendo, estamos experimentando. Ok, turn. So lo dejamos ahí un rato, que se cuele. Y ahorita volvemos con ustedes.
3,
2. ¡Uno!
¡Hola!
No. Ok, so ya está listo el café.
Sí.
Supuestamente. So ahora simplemente lo que hacemos es darle hacia abajo. Ya. Supuestamente ya eso debe tenerlo colado. Ahora. Ok, so para Lía tiene que estar frío.
The coffee needs to be chilled because if we put it in right now with the ice cubes, it'll melt the ice cubes and then it will make that blended consistency. So now we have to put this in the freezer if you want it quicker or the fridge to make it chilled and cold.
So a mí honestamente no me importa, so simplemente lo voy a hacer así. So mientras el de ella se enfría, yo voy a estar terminando el mío y una vez el de ella esté frío, ella terminará el de ella. So por ahora vamos a hacer el mío. Tú coges tu café, lo pones en el refrigerador. Mientras tanto, yo hago el resto.
Okay.
You got that?
Mm-hmm. So, pour some of mine out and then put in the fridge.
Mine and yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. Tiene que ser un cuarto. Ese es lo que las órdenes decían.
It just needs two shots of espresso. But we just didn't have espresso, so we're using regular coffee, but sí. Cooked it strong, so then we just put one third.
So, un tercio de café.
I'm gonna put it in my cup to put in the fridge.
Ponemos ahí.
That's all I need for mine.
Ese es el vaso de ella, lo pone en el refrigerador. Y el mío, como me gusta el café, voy a tratar de hacer un poco más como para que me sobre. Vamos a hacer un tercio de café. Ah, echámosle un medio, echámosle un cuarto, un café entero, una copa entera de café. Eso mismo. Una copa entera de café. Se la echamos al. ¿Cómo la quiere en este vaso? Le echamos en ese vaso ahí. No sé por qué la estamos echando en este vaso. Bueno, el tal es que después.
Bounty, the quicker picker
off of it. Bueno, mi receta decía que le echara cuanto café usted quisiera y luego lo endulzara a como usted quisiera. So, yo lo voy a poner. Te lo voy a tocar aquí. La proteína se combina. Y entonces, una vez ya batido, le echa cuanto usted quiera.
Can you show them the brand?
El brand es el Coffee Mate. Costó como $3, creo. $3.
I think so.
No sé. Echémosles, no sé, una... A fourth, un cuarto.
Why would you say one fourth and then pour so much more than one fourth? You're like, one fourth and then pour the freaking thing in.
Okay, es cuanto usted quiera. Ahí ya tenemos el café listo. Un poquito dulce, pero no pasa nada, no pasa nada, no hay problema, nada de nervio. Entonces venimos hacia acá, le echamos, unos cuantos, mira, recomí. So, verdaderamente no sé cuánto hielo le eché, simplemente échele hielo. A como usted quiera. El tal es que una vez tenga el hielo. Ay, miércoles, era el café. Okay. Primero era el café y luego era el hielo.
This is like a bad food show.
No sé por qué es importante, pero la persona que lo está haciendo en YouTube dijo que tenía que ser así. So, anyways, pones el café, pones el hielo. Oh, y después le pones el. Ya le sé. No sé cuánta leche.
Did you shake it?
Yes. So, yo voy a hacer el almond milk.
Show the cup.
Oh.
Pour back in.
Una copa de leche.
You're not even following any instructions from anybody.
Some milk. Un poquito de leche ahí, como ustedes quieran. Y luego.
Wait, hold on. You guys ever seen those food cooking shows on TV where they're like live and it's like a hot mess, but they're trying to keep it together because it's live? That's exactly what I feel like I'm watching.
It's not a hot mess.
It is a hot mess. You're like, look, it's you. And then you're like, one fourth, and then pour the whole thing in. Mine's gonna be so much more that people can actually follow and like take recipes out. So I'm using measuring. I thought you said you wanted us to watch.
Oh. Okay, empecemos de nuevo. Le echamos las
cucharadas. Exactly what I said. Mess. Trying to keep it together.
Le echamos unas cuantas cucharadas de caramelo y ya, que licúa. So, mejor me licúine.
Huh?
Mejor me licúine. So, hay que licúine this thing. And then... Batelo. Vamos a ver.
Necesito un poquito más de hielo. Don't use my stuff. Don't put too much ice because I need ice too. That's because you're not using measurements. I told you need a cup. You're like, no, you don't.
Así lo hacen los expertos. Los expertos.
But I thought you wanted to do this so they could follow. Sí, you're not even using.
Los expertos le echan ahí por echarle y.
They don't even gonna know how to follow.
Un poquito más de café ahí como para.
You're just adding at this point.
Un poquito más de leche. Listo, licúa.
Follow my tutorial because it'll be a lot better than.
Yeah, follow my tutorial too. What do you mean?
You're like, oh, use 1/4 and then pour all the cream. And I'm like, oh, yeah, use this. And then pour something totally different.
Supuestamente uno le echa que caramelo por aquí. A las. Es como las. A los lados. Para que el caramelo se caiga. Luego, look at that. Look at that.
Look at that. Esto se ve bien.
Y después se echa en el Starbucks Cup. Como,
sí, Starbucks Cup.
You look like Chinese trying to get done with the video.
Bam.
Yeah, we're trying to taste like it.
Y luego le echas el caramelo o arequipe. Y haces una. Listo. There you have it. And there you have it. The ultimate caramelo frappuccino.
Oh. Y ya tienes que poner esta copita ahí encima para que sea más bonito.
Okay, so mine is going to be actually following a recipe that I found on Google on how to make an exact mocha frappuccino Starbucks, but just at home. So mine's going to be more following numbers. Okay, so it says, in a blender, add 1 cup of ice. So if you could actually get me 1 cup of ice in there. And 1/2 cup of chilled espresso, which is earlier what this was. It wasn't espresso, but we just made the coffee extra strong. That's in here. Good, I have a bowl right there. Okay, so now we have our cup. Now we have our cup of ice, which I'm gonna go ahead and pour into there. Cause this recipe, I think, is just making like a small at Starbucks, just for like one personal small one. That's why it's a little bit smaller than what his was. Then I'm gonna pour that 1/3 of the espresso slash just strong coffee. Add 1/3 cup of milk, any milk that you want. So I'm grabbing the milk that I typically always drink, and we're just gonna pour 1/3. So this is 1/3 of milk.
Un tercio.
Either way, you guys hear I'm saying 1/3. 1/3 of milk. Then it says 1 tablespoon of granulated sugar. So now the sugar, it didn't tell me a specific brand to get of the sugar. I honestly have never really used sugar before for anything, so I just picked this one. I don't know if this is a good brand, bad brand, I don't know, but I figured sugar is sugar. I don't think I have my back. 1 tablespoon of granulated sugar. So I'm just gonna shake this off so it's exactly 1 tablespoon because I don't want the extra. So 1 tablespoon right here. Then it says 2 tablespoons of chocolate syrup and blend for about 30 seconds. So now let me open my chocolate syrup. I just got my Hershey's. It also didn't recommend a specific chocolate. So wherever you are in the world or whatever, and you just have a specific, there are a bunch of options and you just like a preferred brand, use that one. I just always use this one, this is my favorite. So it says 2 tablespoons of this. It actually looks really good so far. It looks like what I see at Starbucks, to be honest, and I'm not even putting my own along. Okay, so now that this is all done, it wants us to blend for 30 seconds or until smooth. So let's just try for 30 seconds, see where we're at, go from there. So I'm gonna come over to the blender. Make sure it's locked in place. And then, so I'm just gonna go with milkshake. Okay, so that was about 30 seconds. It actually looks, I feel like, how it does at Starbucks. Oh my God, smell it. Oh my God, okay.
Honestly, it looks a lot better.
All right, so I think it's pretty blended. Pretty things to add some more mocha, so we're gonna go ahead and do that. It's a little light right now, so I'm just gonna go in and then I'm just gonna keep adding what I need to add. So this part, I feel like you guys should just be tasting on your own and freehanding it to see like what's your preference level. All right, so.
I don't know, something.
It looks chocolatey. I might have put a little bit too much, but I guess you could always add more, a little more milk.
Let me try.
I love it.
So the recipe that I followed is right online. I literally went on Google and I just typed in how to make a Starbucks mocha frappuccino at home. And then this is the first thing that popped up. You just click on the first thing that popped up and it's called Eugenie Kitchen. It should look something like that.
We'll put the link down below.
Yeah, and it was super simple, guys. I think if you guys really wanna try it, I think it's really close to being spot on to Starbucks. I don't know how Starbucks does it, but it's really close.
Eso fue todo por hoy. Tenemos nuestros Starbucks Cup.
Cheers.
Yo creo que estuvo bien. Un poco desorganizado de mi parte, pero sabe rico, eso uno le echa las cosas ahí, eso como salga. De todas maneras, gracias por ver, comentar, gustar y suscribirse.
So thank you guys so much for watching in English. Yes. Make sure to like, comment, share and subscribe.
Yes, thank you very much.
We're almost at 100 subscribers.
Yes, so
we're just gonna tell you guys now.
Yes.
Just to get you guys, you know, subscribing to us.
Yes. Yes.
Whoever is our 100th subscriber, which we'll know because our analytics tell us exactly who. We are going to cash out them $100. Yep. As soon as you subscribe, you guys should leave a comment underneath saying that you guys subscribed and that you guys followed us on social media.
Yes.
And then we'll message you if you were the 100th subscriber, get your info, see whatever, and we're gonna cash you guys $100 in honor of our 100th subscriber.
Yes.
So make sure you guys subscribe, get your mom, get your grandma, get your everybody to subscribe if you want that $100.
Yes. Ahora en español, a la persona que ocupe ese lugar, el 100, vamos a mandarle $100 por seguirnos y por completar 100 suscriptores. So, muchas gracias a todos. So, estén pendientes para que se gane esa plata. De todas maneras, muchas gracias por ver. El próximo video va a ser un poco más organizado.
Just like, share, comment, subscribe. Especially if you want that $100.
Yes, thank you guys.
Comment
just let us know how we did so we can better ourselves. Okay, well, thank you guys and goodbye.
Bye.